The broadcast is now starting. All attendees are in listen-only mode.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to TechGig webinar series, our endeavor to empower techies. We believe that sharing of knowledge is the key to enhance our skills and grow us as professionals. With this principle in mind, we have initiated a series of webinars conducted by industry experts to give you all a crisp insight of various domains. The topic of today's session is Big Data Applications from an analyst viewpoint. Our guest speaker today is Pritam Kanti Paul. He is co-founder and director, Products and Solutions, Bridge I2I Analytics Solutions. Known as an innovative thinker, Pritam has led development and implementation of several high-impact and cutting-edge analytical solutions for Hewlett-Packard and General Electric. Pritam holds MS in Statistics degree from Indian Statistical Institute, Kolkata, and have played leadership role in developing the large analytic setups of GE, now which is Genpact, and a HP from scratch. He has experience of implementing analytics across marketing, sales, risk management, and operations. Pritam is leading Bridge I2I efforts in building technology and solutions to make analytics and big data accessible, affordable, and available for larger audience, and thus creating sustained impact for businesses. So, without further delay, I introduce you all to our guest speaker. Over to you, Pritam.
Thanks for the intro, Aradhana, and thanks for the invitation to speak. Hopefully,
continue with the presentation.
Next 45 minutes, as we talk through. You can hear me, right, Aradhana?
Loud and clear. You can please start.
Sure. Thanks to all the participants who joined. Hopefully, the 45 minutes or 1 hour we speak today is worthwhile for all of you. As we talked about the agenda of today is really understanding big data from a business analytics perspective, and we'll talk about why you should be bothered, what's the current status today, and the huge applications it can really bring in today's world. At the same time, we'll also take a look at how big data initiatives are really running across the world and what can really derail the potential. It has a lot of excitement around it, but there are possibilities of getting derailed, and we'll take a look at that and see how probably analysts look at those situations and try to find out solutions for them. So without kind of spending more time on the agenda, I'll move to the next page. Okay, so there are few changes which has really happened in recent years, in the last last 10 to 15 years, as the storage cost has significantly gone down, and not only the cost but also the size of storage has gone down significantly, which allowed all the businesses to keep more and more information, be it informative, be it not informative, be it apparently looking maybe a garbage, but still people can keep more and more information. At the same time, there are a lot of new technologies which has come, which allowed to keep this data in a much more structured way, which allowed better processing of data, which allowed probably a cycle of data to access to data being crunched to much, much smaller time than what it used to be at some point of time, which not only allowed people to keep the data, but also allowed people to process the data more easily and make it much more accessible for a broader people in a much faster way. At the same time, on the other side, there had been few companies who made significant impact in their business processes through use of analytics. And I don't say that they have only made impact. I would say their business processes were really based on analytics. to name a few, like Netflix, Capital One, Marriott. They're really called as analytics competitors, a set of companies who create their business model based on analytics and based on data. And at the same time, we have seen emergence of LinkedIn, Facebook, Amazon, and they are creating huge amount of data, you know, at a day-by-day basis.